All right, we have got Jake with Black Sheep Skid, and this is the original Psycho Hillbilly Skid Steer Stuntman. Jake, thanks for being on with us today.
Hey, thanks for having me, Stan.
First thing I'm going to warn you guys is do not attempt anything that you are about to see. There's no safety nets, there's no safety gear. It's raw skill, and this guy makes it look easy. He's running a stock skid loader. It's not modified in any way, shape, or form, and it's just pure death-defying
Thanks for having me, Stan.
How the heck did you get started doing some of the crazy stuff that you're doing?
Back in 2007, I started my own landscape company, running a S130 skid loader, and everything was tight quarters, so I just learned how to get on my back tires and spin around in tight confined spaces and spread material, flip on my front two tires and spin around without tearing up the material. So I realized how effective it was for me to go and do the work, not have to come back and fix things by spinning on all fours or skidding on all fours. And plus, getting down into drainage ditches, I'm able to get down and up and out without dragging my back end. As people know, with a skid loader, sometimes you have to get an excavator to go dig out ditches, but I'll just whip down there on my front two tires, spin a 90, pick up rocks, spin out of it, and climb up out of the hill. And so that's been a very effective for me. And then back in 2009, a county fair, our local county fair, they asked me to come and put on Mini X skid steer competition. And first time I had ever done it. So I got equipment out there and put some courses and built some mounds. And I figured out on those mounds that I had built for a race course for skid steers to go over, which was super dangerous and ridiculous. These things were like super cross jumps. And I'm thinking it was a good idea to have people race skid steers up and over them, but man, it was dangerous. So I eliminated that and decided while I was there for 3 days to do something with them. So I learned how to ride up these mounds on my front two tires. The following year, they asked me to come out to Vegas and pick out entertainment for our fair in 2010, 2011. When I was there at that convention in Vegas, I saw these entertainers, so many different types of entertainers that were there, and the price that they were charging. And I was thinking, man, what can I do with my skid loader, and what can I put together that I can travel with and make money doing this stuff? So my wheels were spinning after that convention, and I came back. I knew a guy that was selling these 72-foot metal trusses, and I asked him to buy them from him. And so I purchased these two trusses and fabricated them together. Spent like $10,000 on this rel and scheduled my local rodeo to entertain there without even knowing if I could climb this thing. By the time this thing was done and a couple of months of all this hype around town about how retarded I am for climbing this rail. Oh yeah, Jake Hatch thinks he's going to climb this rail on a skid loader on his front two tires. I was basically...
Dude, that is awesome. That is awesome. So you had never climbed it up to that point.
No.
You had advertised you were going to do this.
Right.
How do you sit in the skid loader? Are your balls so big that you actually have room in there for your legs?
Oh, dude, I'll tell you what, man. They were sweaty, and my palms were sweaty. And when I went to climb this rail the first time, I had people there. I attempted to go up it, and my thought was, what are you doing? You could kill yourself. This is not smart. But, I also had connected with Guinness Book of World Record and scheduled for me to break a world record. Some guy held a 50-foot world record riding the longest wheelie on his front two tires. So this rail that I built 72 foot long. So I was like, you know what? I was pretty much committed to this. With all this on my mind, I just went for it. And by the time I got to the top of that rail, I realized this is possible. And all the fear basically just went away. I was able to go down, whip around, come back, climb it again with ease. And ever since then, I've been trying to come up with an idea on how to make this rail portable because it's just too much. So I came up with the idea to split it in half, and I built this platform on the end of it. And so now I ride up this half rail up to a platform, and I'm able to spin around on top of it, and that was pretty sketch the first time I did it. It's pretty nerve-wracking to be able to spin that high.
Jake, I think everything you do is pretty sketch, bud. You are crazy, man. You are crazy, dude. Some of the stuff I have seen you do blows my mind, and you make it look so easy, and it's not. I mean, it is literally one of those things you either get or you don't get. What do you think?
It's just practice, you know. Anybody can do it. It just takes a lot of hours. I'm estimated to have at least 7,000 hours at this point.
Wait a minute, 7,000 hours just on your front tires, I'm going to guess.
You know, I just started advertising last year that I'm available across the country. So I went, I took my snow bucket and fabricated 4 go-kart seats in it with 5-point harness seat belts in it. So I get kids and elderly people, and I strap them in. I get on my front 2 tires, give them a little G-force, spin them around, lift them up and down. They love it. It's a blast.
Jake, I love your story, man, and your skills are out of this world. So one last question for you, Jake.
Yeah.
What piece of equipment do you use?
Most people are familiar with the 753 or the S130. Yeah. I purchased a brand new S450, which is the same size. So that's what I use. You know, they've got a tighter wheelbase, and so I'm able to get on my front and back a lot easier. The bigger you go, you know, the more thrust you have to have.
But your machine is pure stock, not modified in any way, shape, or form.
Not at all. Yeah, it's pure stock. A lot of people ask me that question. You know, what did you do? Do you have counterweights in there? Nope. Bought it straight from Bingham Equipment and loaded it onto my truck without ramps and on my way. It's the paint job.
And hand-foot controls versus joystick controls, right?
Absolutely. Hydraulic over hydraulic is the best way to go. You know, it's very precise. It reacts to every little move that you make. So when you've got electric over hydraulic, there's a bit of delay. And when I'm doing construction work, I want to work with something that's precise, something that can grade around stem walls without me worrying about, oh, crap, boom. You know, too late with electric over hydraulic. So I like hydraulic over hydraulic for sure.
Same here, Jake. 100%. I'll take that any day of the week.
Yeah.
Last thing, how do people find you? How do they get a hold of you, Jake?
You can get on blacksheepskid.com, and they can find me there. Email me through my website. Require if there's somebody who's interested in hiring me for a fair or a rodeo, they can get on there and fill out an application, and I can get some details worked out with them.
Blacksheepskid.com.
I've got a Facebook page, Black Sheep Skid. I've got an Instagram, Black Sheep Skid.
And you're available for fairs and other events.
Fairs and rodeos, yeah. State fairs, whatever. Any kind of festival that would be interested.
What you're doing is absolutely awesome. Thank you.